Each year, dedicated fans of horror shows spend upwards of $1 billion to open up their minds, hearts, and living rooms to zombies, serial killers, demons, and blood-soaked gore. The question is, why? What is it that draws people, even skittish, anxiety-riddled, regular folks, into this form of entertainment? For some, the physical reaction to fright causes a dopamine release, leading to a neurochemical calm after the storm. This leads to an increased sense of well-being and quiet, even a sense of pleasure. It feels good to go into a scary situation and come out safely. Some feel a need to induce a sense of fear to create closeness and even connection with others. Repeatedly shocking yourself this way can have a desensitization effect on your brain, emotions, and body. The calm is only temporary. The problem is it doesn't deal with the root of your fear. It further authorizes the deadly lie that you've taken in to continue to feed the monster of fear tormenting you. Pam and I know the road manager for a very famous female country singer. She does a concert and then watches horror movies on her tour bus all night. As you can imagine, it takes a toll on her personally. Her manager told us that this iconic artist can't even sleep without all the lights on. The manager suggested that she quit the horror flicks, but unfortunately, she craves that temporary dopamine hit she gets when the monster is conquered by the end of the show. Crazy? I don't think so. Ignorance will always draw what's harmful into your soul in place of what's authentic. Pain and rejection trigger a desperation for relief, so you instinctively react, like this singer who chooses horror movies to support her subconscious desire for the calm that follows her controlled fear spike. The problem with this is that life responds to a limited set of targets. As we've heard, she lived with great fear in her life, even of the dark. She's successful as a pop country singer, but daily she lives as a failure in life, afraid of even her own shadow. Her focus sabotages her peace. Doing one thing good doesn't compensate for doing one thing bad. Romans 12:2 says, "Don't be conformed to this world, but rather be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God." When you conform to something, you take its shape. Many people take the shape of their pain and dysphoria to survive. An abused wife learns to redefine abuse as possessive love. A rejected child learns to shield his heart with anger and rage. In each case, their true identities have been twisted by lies. The true power of life comes with believing God's truth and then continually being transformed by meditating on it. That's the beauty of focusing on God's Word. It has transforming power, proving what is that good and perfect will for you. Don't settle for substitutes or a temporary fix. Don't conform when you can transform and experience the power of God. Philippians 4:7 says to think on whatever is true, honorable, good, pure, and beautiful. Why go through life with a living dead focus? God's Word has the power to make the dead alive again, not looking like a zombie either. Jesus is the resurrection and the life. He makes all things new. He casts demons out and down with His Word. He calms storms, raises the dead, and He has dispossessed the devil of the keys of hell and the grave. Yes, that just spoils the plot and premise of every horror flick. And who cares? Jesus don't do zombies. Jesus defeated death. Jesus makes sons and daughters of God the Almighty. Now let's pray the Word. Praise God. 1 Corinthians 15:54 announces that death is swallowed up in victory and forever lost its sting. Jesus, you have forever conquered the greatest fear and tormentor of humanity, death. You were born of a virgin, lived a sinless life. You died on the cross for our sins, descended into the grave, taking the keys of death, hell, and the grave. You rose victorious on the third day, and now reign as King of Kings at the right hand of Father God. We choose to meditate on your truth so that we can tap your transforming power in our lives. We only have room for a limited focus, a limited set of targets, so we meditate on what is true, honorable, right, pure, beautiful, and admirable, that we might have the abundant life you promised us. All glory be to you, Lord Jesus. Amen. If you just prayed that prayer with me and gave your life to Jesus, reach out and let somebody know. We want to celebrate with you and introduce you to believers of like faith. To get even more encouragement, go to www.lifetalkspodcast.com. Remember, we love you and we're praying for you.